So a new car that's coming off Porsche is the Porsche Taycan. They're doing two models, a standard model and a turbo. God knows why they've called an electric car a turbo, but that's Porsche for you. It's got an 800 volt charging system, which means it'll be one of the fastest charging cars that comes to market. They've achieved this by splitting two 400 packs and combining them both to get an 800 volt system. This allows them a couple of advantages. One of the advantages is faster charging times and the ability to charge on lower charges at still high rates. The Porsche Taycan Turbo has a 0-60 time in 2.8 seconds, and unlike some other cars in the electric sort of era, this can do repeat performance at that speed at 2.8 seconds with no fade time. So it really is a true Porsche at heart. What's a little bit different in the back of the Porsche is there is a touchscreen for the air conditioning controls, which is completely different. I've never seen it before in another car. It's got heat control. You even can select exactly the airflow, very similar to the way the Model 3 does it. The seats are very comfortable in the back, nice big seating position. It's just beautiful. So one thing they've done, which is different to the Model 3, is they've actually incorporated buttons into the screen itself. And it's a very, very clever idea. Rather than just having the center console control everything, you've physically got your lights here. It's all touchscreen, it's just beautiful. There's this lovely little drive scroll wheel here that changes the driving mode from sport, normal, sport plus and range for the maximum eco performance. The steering wheel is expected, of course, very high quality. It's beautiful. They've even incorporated a little chrono clock at the top. And again, in the middle console, you've got exactly the same controls as what you have in the back. And then you've got full screens all the way down for the driver and obviously the co-pilot. Charlie, you are a self-confessed Porsche fan.
For sure. Yeah. For sure. I've witnessed all of their last wins at Le Mans. Mark Webber, well, he didn't win, but people like Brandon Hartley, Nico Hülkenberg, Nick Tandy, heroes of mine, Steve McQueen. Who doesn't love Steve McQueen? Yeah.
The Taycan, is it what you expected from the pictures?
It's freaking awesome. Yeah. Freaking awesome. It is a Porsche through and through, and they have thought of everything.
Now, when I sat inside before, the infotainment system, mm-hmm. You said it was designed...
It was designed by Porsche, so Porsche design, but they've integrated things like Apple Music. So that means that Apple have actually invested in working with Porsche, and that's really, really exciting because that is a move that Apple have never made before. It's not CarPlay, it's integrated into the Porsche.
You can see that some of the design language is definitely Apple. So I was saying before, unlike the Tesla where you've got a center dash that controls your everything, Porsche have been very clever that they haven't done that. They've incorporated buttons that are touch buttons.
Yeah, absolutely. So when you're driving hard, all the buttons that you need to be able to access are things like suspension settings, traction control lights are all around the edges of the infotainment system, which you can hold and then access the buttons.
How much does it start at?
Top end starts at about 135.
That's the top,
top end.
That's the top end.
Bottom end starts at the moment at 115,000. There's a talk of other models, single motor models, things like that.
Yeah, because the first lot of models are going to be four wheel drive only.
For sure.
And then they're thinking of doing a real world motor system. I mean,
And an RS. There's rumour of an RS, which would just be...
I mean, what's nice is everyone talks of electric cars being the death of ICE cars. What people forget is electric cars, Johnny Smith was saying the other day, electric cars have brought back real-wheel drive motor systems again, which is a petrolhead's dream, is real-wheel motors. And electric cars are all becoming real-wheel motors and front-wheel drive or four-wheel drive systems.
Yeah, there's a definitive different way of building. You're not constrained. Designers aren't constrained by what was being cheap or what has been easy before. What's cheap and easy now is different. So that makes it and makes balance, and they can sell on amazing benefits from things like rear-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, like intelligent all-wheel drive as well. It's incredible.
And your company where you work at the moment, Octopus EVs, are going to be doing this car on leasing.
I can't promise, but that's the plan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, as a Porsche fan, how much of your salary can you sacrifice?
I'll be working for minimum wage.
You definitely want one.
Yeah.
Yeah. More than a Tesla? Yeah. And you're a Tesla fanboy. You are a Tesla fanboy.
I raced for Tesla.
So you're a Tesla fanboy and you want the Porsche. And on that bombshell, thank you very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to click subscribe. Don't forget to like this video and check out my other videos. Thanks very much from Charlie from Oxford TV for bringing me here to the Frankfurt Motor Show. There's a lot more videos from the Frankfurt Motor Show on my channel. Make sure you check them out.
Awesome.